Imagine coming home and having to walk through open sewage running through your neighborhood streets and around your house. You pass by mountains of rotting rubbish that have been sitting uncollected for months. Once at home, you go to get some water to wash yourself, but nothing comes out of the tap, and you can't go to your toilet because it's backed up and possibly spilling into your home.
As you can see, like at the site, we have the problem of sewage up there, right? So this is leading to underground water contamination. You have sewage almost in every corner, right? And the sewage is not being attended to by the responsible authority. So this is leading to groundwater contamination, which is very difficult for the community to understand what we mean by underground contamination. They just get the water and they drink. The main problem is the water. There is no tap water. There are some houses that have gone for about a year without tap water, some houses 6 months and so forth. So the community is left without any option but to drink water from any source, including open shallow wells. They just get the water. At times they don't even boil it.
This is our second year without any water coming from the tap. So we really don't know when we are going to have it anyway. There is cholera, there is all these diseases which are coming up now because of that. And some of our guys are even collecting water from dirty points, you see, which is causing a lot of these dysentery and cholera diseases coming to come up. We spend most of our time there fetching water instead of doing some other precious things.
It's just adjacent to the pit. Whenever the rain comes, it goes right on top of that, the rubble. Then it goes down, maybe to go, come to the wall. That will have to affect that. And we can get cholera about it.
Yes. Yeah.
So I'm very much worried about this.
These have been the conditions many Zimbabweans have been living in for the past year, and which has unfortunately led to the biggest cholera outbreak this country has ever seen. Under these conditions, a cholera outbreak is almost inevitable. And it has hit Zimbabwe with unprecedented force. Over 90,000 have been affected up to today, while the epidemic is far from over.
It's coming so quick, and you die so quick, and it's coming in mass. I can't even explain how it was, with all these wheelbarrows coming in. And it seems for me, I was only in the CTC, it seems like everybody's sick. The complete health system is more or less broken down. Now it's working a little bit, but they can't afford to go to a doctor. So everybody's trying to slip in. And I can understand that. We don't have the capacity and we don't have the medication to treat. That's kind of hard.
So this is an example of a family. The father and the whole family came in yesterday. The father is in the male ward. The mother is here with two kids. Both of the kids arrived in a very, very severe state. In shock state. Both of them have woken up by now. They're looking at us. So they're reacting again, which is very nice, which is due to the IV rehydration that was given. I come from a neighborhood where just now in the past few days, again, numbers spiked because of water shortages or even water cuts. Not enough boreholes to fetch water, water being fetched from unsafe wells. And we've seen this, and we have actually already sent the water and sanitary person out of our team. He's now just now assessing the situation and trying to start a bucket chlorination program there so that every family, every person who fetches water from an unsafe place has gets a little bit of chlorine into their bucket, which makes the water safe to drink.
Apart from setting up many cholera treatment centers around the country and treating tens of thousands of patients, MSF has also concentrated on preventative measures. Water sanitation experts have set up a wide network of MSF volunteers who chlorinate people's water and make it safe for drinking. There are 161 MSF volunteers stationed in high-density townships covering a population of 120,000 residents.
We have selected many wells in Budiriro 1 and some boreholes. The water is free for everyone. Okay, even at the private houses, the water is free.
Clean and safe water is a basic necessity and a vital part of life, and should be easily accessible to everyone.